This is Janet again with Paper and Spark, and I'm here with part 3 of the PayPal Seller Spreadsheet Tutorial Series. In this video, we're going to learn how to use the product expenses and the business expenses section of the spreadsheet and those purple and pink tabs. Okay, next we have our product expenses and our business expenses, and these two sections are both pretty much identical to how the Etsy salary spreadsheet works. So I am going to direct you to the videos that explain those two tabs from the Etsy seller spreadsheet video tutorials. It still works the same. I just am warning you, because if you're watching the videos and you notice that the monthly tab looks a little different, it's because it's the Etsy version of the spreadsheet. For your product expenses, we're going to have two little categories: direct raw materials and indirect materials and tools. Basically, your product expenses are going to be anything that you purchase to make your products. So obviously this depends greatly on what you're making and what you're selling. But, you know, if you make purses, you sew purses, then your materials are going to be things like fabric, zippers, thread, elastic, interfacing, buttons, etc., on and on and on. Now, what's the difference between direct and indirect? A direct raw material is something that you can trace to a specific good. So if you bought zippers, then a zipper is a direct raw material because you can know the cost of that one zipper that's in that purse. Indirect raw materials and tools are going to be things that aren't really easily traceable to a specific product. So, for example, that could be your sewing machine. A sewing machine is a requirement to make your product, but you can't allocate a cost of the sewing machine on a product-by-product basis. You need it for all your products, right? Now, the difference between these two categories is not really that important for purposes of this spreadsheet. It's more important when you talk about pricing and cost of goods sold and cost of goods made. And for this spreadsheet, we're really just looking at your monthly total expenses. So we're entering your product expenses, whether direct or indirect. We're entering them just as you purchase them. We're on a monthly total basis. So if I am a jewelry designer and I'm selling pearl necklaces and I buy a bunch of pearls in January, then I'm going to enter the cost of all those pearls in January. It doesn't matter if I use them all in necklaces in that month, and it doesn't matter if I sell necklaces made with those pearls in that month. I'm just entering the expenses that I paid in that month. For purposes of this spreadsheet, we're just trying to get total revenue minus total expenses right now. I hope that concept makes sense to you. We will be having a separate spreadsheet for pricing and inventory and costing your goods sold and your goods made. And that's when it matters more on coming up with a price per item and per unit for your raw materials. But for purposes of this spreadsheet, we're just looking at your total expenses for raw materials, no matter when you use them. Next, we have the third and final category of your expenses, and that's your business expenses. This is basically where all the things that didn't fall into the other two categories are going to go. So all the other costs that your business has, whether they be for printing materials like business cards or your web hosting fee for your blog or the graphic designer cost for designing your logo, or you know, the ribbon and the jewelry boxes that you ship your items in, or photo props, whatever, all those other business expenses are going to fall into this category. And this also can depend a lot on what your Etsy shop sells, what kind of business you are. So that's why we've included 3 customizable rows, again, for you to name whatever expense category makes the most sense for you. Feel free to put them here. So now that we've kind of gone through the main lines on this monthly summary tab, these numbers will get you to your net profit, which is your total revenue minus your total expenses. Now on to our product expenses. We're going to enter our product expenses on this pink tab called product expenses. Now, your raw material and tool expenses can vary greatly depending on what type of business you are and what type of products you sell. So this tab is ready for you to customize. Right now, it's just these generic material names, but you know, feel free to customize them for what makes sense to you. If I'm a jewelry business, then I'll probably have some categories that look kind of like this. So, these are the types of things that I might be entering here. Okay, you can rename them whatever makes the most sense for you. And this tab, unfortunately, just requires work. There's no easy way to import data here. This requires you to log in every month and enter the expenses of the supplies that you buy. I would encourage you to go ahead and fill this in as you purchase raw materials and not wait till the end of the month to do it, especially if you buy a lot of supplies each month. I do it as you buy them just to make it easier and make sure that you don't accidentally miss anything. And remember, when we're manually entering multiple expenses in the same cell, you're going to want to use the equal sign first. And then you're going to type your numbers with the plus sign between them, okay? If you try and enter multiple numbers without that equal sign, like this, it's not going to work for you because the equal sign is what tells your spreadsheet that it's a formula adding multiple numbers together. And as we previously discussed, with our raw materials, we are going to enter them on the spreadsheet in bulk as we actually purchase them. We're not going to wait to enter them until we use them in a product or you sell them via a product. We're going to enter them as the cost actually comes out of our pockets, okay? So I'm going to enter some fake totals here so that I can get some numbers. And then these sums are going to flow to the pink rows on my monthly summary spreadsheet. So again, I'm just getting to see all my expenses for the month in one place. Finally, I have my business expenses, which are purple and flow from the business expenses tab. And again, this is going to be a set of expenses that depends a lot on you and your business. So you can rename all these expense types to whatever category or name makes the most sense to you. So I might put like web hosting expenses, and I might have graphic designer fees, and I might put printing for like promotional materials, and that might be some of the things that I have. So I pay $10 a month for my web hosting, and I paid my graphic designer $100 in January, and then I paid $22 for my craft jewelry boxes that I ship my items in. Obviously, you will have more detailed expenses than this. This is just for example's sake. But these numbers as well will flow over here to the monthly summary tab. If I have some more expense categories that I want to keep track of, I'd rename these lines here and enter them manually. So let's say I have my phone line that's directly for my business. So I might make another category for utilities, and then have an extra expense right there. Okay, so now I've got my total expenses for January. And the spreadsheet has calculated a net profit figure, and that's simply this total revenue less these total expenses. So I can see this number is positive. So I did have a profit in January, and that is basically what you do. So I would continue to do that each month, and as I generate numbers for February, my year column will change. This number, these numbers right here, will always show me a running annual balance. So I'll know if, you know, hey, maybe I didn't make a profit in January or February, but I did make a profit in March, April, May. So I can see whether or not I've broken even for the year yet, or, you know, what my average is, that kind of thing. That's it for the main part of the PayPal seller spreadsheet. We've covered revenue and we've covered expenses. Stay tuned for the very last video of the series, which will cover how to use this green sales tax for state purposes area.